Hey, boys and girls, this is Wildman, Willis here, and I'm doing a review of the new documentary, The Resurrection of Jake the Snake Roberts. Well, us wrestling fans love Jake the Snake Roberts, his run in the 80s in WWE as the sinister Snake Man himself with the big old boa constrictor Damien in his bag. Was a delight to fans, heel or face. Never really won any major titles in WWE, but who cares? He was Jake the Snake. He didn't need no damn titles. So it's basically chronicles his life to recovery, all the way up to his Hall of Fame speech at WrestleMania, which is always a feel-good experience to see. Good to see how Jake has recovered from drugs and alcohol and all the demons that follow him with the help of Diamond Dallas Page, which you should commend Page for helping the people that helped him when he was trying to get into the business and also helping his friends out when they really need him. He don't have to do that, but that's something that's in his heart, which is genuine, and I'm very happy about it. It also chronicles the recovery of Scott Hall as well in this documentary. So it's just not all about Jake. It's also how Diamond Dallas Page helped Scott Hall as well. Like I just mentioned earlier, both of them had their little hiccups and missteps because they're all human. And Jake had a lot of stuff to deal with in his childhood, which they talk about in the documentary. You get sound bites from legends such as Stone Cold Steve Austin, Chris Jericho, Jim Ross, and many other luminaries from WWE's past, present, and present. And it was good to see Jake on recovery, and hopefully he keeps down this road, because this was a feel-good moment for a lot of wrestling fans, and it's a good look into how people affect one another, not just in their daily lives, but all around the world. And we're thankful for Jake being well, and this was a very good documentary. Give it up to Diamond Dallas Page and his production company, and also shows the power of DDP Yoga, so I'm glad to be able to watch this experience. I'm glad to have Jake around to be able to share his stories with his family, which is important to him, and I'm glad that he got a chance to come back to WWE and be part of the family. And that's it for my review. This is Wildman Willis signing off. See you next time.